credit. Back one more time. I'm all prepared here. I'm going to do a couple decals. Now, I've never used Mark Fit Strong. In fact, I just broke the seal on the bottle. And since I'm not going to use these decals here, I'm going to go ahead and do a test decal on my paint mule using Mark Fit Strong. Mark Fit Strong is a Tamiya product, and these are Tamiya decals, so it should be good to go. Okay, decals in the water. Now, I'm tell you, I'm just skeptical about painting this stuff on my paint job. I've seen it done. Okay. I just don't want to imagine losing. Oh, there's my son. I just don't want to imagine having some kind of error I'm going to put this on spanning a couple ribs here. A little water to make sure I can move it. And then I'm going to squeegee some water out. Now I wish I had a decal like the numbers, because I definitely want to see what goes on with the clear stuff and silvering. Well squeegeed out. Flammable. Fit Strong and don't touch till completely dry. See, I can see an area. Oops. I can see an area where the Mark Fit Strong was. I'm going to brush some right here. take it off with some water. I mean, I'm sure the secret is to not get it anywhere other than where the decal is going. And sure enough, I can see where that was. Well, Dickie stumbles. Hey, Dickie, how's it going? I was enjoying the multi-stream there with the Cavster and the others, but it was time for me to get a little more work done. And I'm having an I don't know situation with this Mark Fitzstrong. And what I don't know is, where it's getting on the paint. I just can't tell if it's, I mean, it should be fine for the paint, but I just can't tell if it's doing anything. Well, I'm going to follow the manufacturer's specifications. I'm going to paint very carefully where it goes. I'm going to rely on the model streams are out today, aren't they? I'm going to rely on keeping it real neat. So I've decided, right, wrong, or indifferent, I've decided I'm going to lay the decal all as one. Why? Because I'm worried about an awkward spacing or the number not being straight. I'm going to lay the decal all as one right across the rudder brake, and and then I will cut the decal later. Myself a new blade in here. So I want to split that two, split the two and the six right down the rudder, with the six going right to the edge of the rudder. It'll be straight with the white lines and right up against that little bulb right below the panel lining for that little bulb. So many variables, yeah, man. Especially with me, because I've got to make it worse than it actually is. I'm going to use this for my brush. This brush is way too big. That brush is fanned way out. Ooh, smells strong. It smells like I don't want to go putting it on my paint. So right across here, down out here. Into the water with ye. Moving, but it's not moving very easily. There we go. Oh, come on, baby. Good placement. Dog hair. It's killer monster straight with the line. And my idea of wanting to pin wash before decals paid off. I got some rivets showing through the clear part. So let me see if I can work this out for the camera here. out of the way. See if that works out a little better for the camera. Decal on straight. Decals away. Yep, on straight. Looks good. Nice clear backing. And I put it on the right face because of that little bulb. I kept telling myself, don't put it on the wrong part of the boom. Don't put it on the wrong part of the boom. I put it on the inside. That would be right up my alley. Okay. So. That looks real good. I'm real pleased with that. Let's go over here, look at my test decal. Yeah, look at that. It's taken right to the panel lines. Okay, now for some with the right brush. Let me not do this right in front of the camera.
It is like a comedy of errors.
That's what?
I got a dog on either side of them and both of them are farting.
Alternately. The dogs don't fart around me that much.
Alternately. One's going.
They're saving them for you. A comedy of errors.
Except Benjo's stink.
Yeah. Sasha's just sounds like people farts.
They're little like puffs of air. Psst, 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 psst. I'm like, you gotta be kidding me.
Okay, now don't touch till it's dry. That's the law. So, now for this one. Dickie says, hey, Miss Egg Shen. For this one, I want to split the one into six. Which put the two decals in a little bit of. Yeah, but I guess that's the way they've got to be. This one looks nice and centered on the tail. And this one will actually be riding just a little bit forward, because if I centered it on the tail in the same manner, then I'd be splitting that six. Dag fights. You like dags? So they went to the movie and they said the movie was only okay. So I don't regret not going to the movie with them. Although I probably missed out on a good lunch. I'm not using my warmer. I have a little coffee cup warmer that my wife got me for doing decals, which I like it. I think it, the warm water really helps the decals release. And then I'm gonna do the insignias up front. They're going to go just off the bottom of the wingtip, centered between that seam and the air intake. Way out of position. Get some water on that sucker. Magnify. I think that's it right there. That's it, man. I'm just trying to impress you, dude. I just want you to think I'm awesome. But you're right, you're already hanging. Let that one dry. Let's take a look at this one. Good. Good with that. So now I need the little insignia. Fancy decal warmer. Sucker right there. It's not going to want to play well going in there with all this excess paper. Okay. When it's straight up and down with the seam, it's going to appear, yeah, with the streams straight up and down. So it's actually almost going to look like it's running a little downhill. I got to center it between those two. And this front corner is going to be just off this tip. That's my height. Into the drink. This stuff smells pretty potent, so I imagine it's gassing off. It's going to evaporate if I don't remember to cap it. And there is a tiny decal that goes on that number. It is number 68. And it is not on this sheet. So I'm wondering, when I use the Mark Fit Strong and I apply it before the decal, does it have to stay wet? It's a Cavster. Got a raid going on. Thanks, Cavs. Just doing a little decal work here before assembly. Figured these would be easier to do laying down on their side. All your viewers aren't here, man. Usually it's just me and Dickie. Most nights, it's just me and Dickie. He comes for my coffee cup warmer. So I hope that's good. Squeeze all this water out here. Doesn't look like part of my paint job. I guess I should have tested that Mark Fit Strong on the gray paint too, which I will do before I get to the other models. I don't know if you can see it there, right next to the insignia right here. That's not something that I painted. That's something that the Mark Fit Strong did to my paint. So that is not pleasing. Get some water on it, it sort of darkens a little bit, but I don't think it's going to wash away. Well, we'll see how it looks when it all dries. So yeah, I'm concerned about the Mark Fit Strong blemishing the paint. And I know I've seen like Andy's Hobbies Headquarters. I've seen him do it. And man, he slaps that stuff all over everything. Okay, so let's put a little more here. When I do that, I'm being real careful just to get it on the decal and not get any on the paint. One. Gotta try to get this thing not to roll around so much. We know. So this time I'm going to be real extra careful about where this goes. That was not real extra careful. So the numbers are looking good. All the clear film vanished accordingly. And on this one, I got some rivets showing through the clear, a couple panel lines. I'm going to hit that again with a little more of the Mark Fit Strong, see if I can get. Looks like it's sinking into the little panel dealies. Everybody else has a stream. How come you're not streaming, Dickie? Not building anything? Come on, baby, let go of that. There we go, a little bit. Station. Yeah, that Mark Fit definitely blemished my gray paint. Make an ugly hand model. And that looks like a tiny little blemish in the paint under, right under the clear border. So it'd be real cool if that color returned, but I don't think it's going to. It's way too, you know, it's way too light. It almost like hit it with white. Let me see if I can get this to focus on that. Right here. It could pass as like, you know, some form of weathering, but that's not how I fly, man. I don't like to do that. Everybody, not everybody, but I see that comment a lot where somebody's like, oh, just call it weathering. No, it's not what I intended to do. I need to make a practice of recovering from such errors. What I'll do is I will cut a tiny little mask out of silly putty and I will give that a little with the airbrush and you'll never know it was there. I got a couple touch-ups to do once I assemble anyway, so touch-ups are coming. I gotta do touch-ups and then I've got to clear coat the touch-ups and then I'm gonna pin wash the whole thing and then finish the decals. Here again, this is looking good. So I am liking how the Mark Fit Strong works. I'm not liking that it blemished my paint. But I'm getting a good response out of it the way it's working. The main thing is this seam here where the rudder line is. I want that to sink in there real good because then I'm going to slice it. And when I slice it, I don't want there to be any loose flappers. Don't touch it. It's probably a little gummy. Let it dry. Let it dry. Okay, now to think about this tiny little date decal number 68. '64, '65, '67, '67, '67, '69, '69, '68. Holy hell. '68 is these two here. They're joined by a little piece of clear and I'm guessing one goes on the inside of the other tail. One's going to go on the number decal and then the other one goes on the inside. Yeah. I don't think I'm doing that. I wonder how tragic it'll be if I don't. Yeah, I'm gonna do plenty of the larger stencils, you know, like these and these larger ones. But these here, like 84 and 85, I am not gonna mess with those. They are just absolutely microscopic. Yeah, it's just incredible that they include all these microscopic things, man. I don't even know how I'd begin to see if I'm even putting them on straight. Well, the other thing I was thinking about is whether or not I should do the shark teeth. They aren't on the layout for this. I'm not gonna do 23 Skidoo, the little Indian there. I'm gonna skip on that. I'm going to do all the no steps. I'm going to do the Japanese flag shoot down tally. I'm going to do a bunch of them, but 67, let me see where 67 goes. I know. I'm taking the cheap way out. Professional decal layer. So I got 4 67s. I guess they all go in the same location on all four sides. You know, if they could be read, if you could actually read them, then I'd be like, you gotta put them on, but there's no hope to ever reading those. Pretty small. I guess these are supposed to be mirrors. I'm supposed to put them on the inside. So let me cut out, what did I say they were, 67. Let me cut out 67, see how they go. Yes. Yes, it did. In fact, this has several gloss coats on it already. Because I did, I painted and then I gloss coated, and I touched up and I gloss coated, and when I did the stripes, I gloss coated because I was going to put tape on the enamel. I mean, I was going to put tape on the acrylic, so I gloss coated. And then after I did the enamel, the white stripes, after I did those, I gloss coated. So it's got a ton of gloss on it already. I don't even know what I'm going to push this thing around with. The brush is probably too big. Toothpick. Definitely gonna need a magnifier for this. That thing is hanging there in a bubble of water. Well, I'll tell you what, it looks pretty cool. Now, last thing we'll do is get this on my gray, because I don't think it played good with my gray. Pretty cool, yo. Round two. Dude, I can't do anything without a magnifier. My eyes were freaking perfect up until I was about 45 years old. And they've been steadily, steadily declining ever since then. I used to, on the highway with my helper in the truck, we used to read out road signs, you know, the big ones up over top of the highway. And we would call them out, the first one that could see them. And he didn't need glasses, and he thought he had good eyesight, but he was amazed at how well, how far away I was able to read that stuff. And now I can't even see what's in front of my face. And I think, because my eyes are two very different forms of screwed up, right now I'm thinking that the way my eyes are and I need new glasses, it's screwing up my depth perception. I'm sitting here trying to paint stuff and stuff like that, and I'm stroking at it and stroking at it, and then I look at it from the side, I'm like, I'm not even touching it. Well, I want to make sure it's facing the right way. I don't want it to go in there upside down, because then I'll look like an idiot. Somebody with eyesight will see it and think I'm a fool. Okay, I'll give it to you. That's pretty cool. That they look pretty good. Station, yo. It's feeling good, looking good, being good. I think this means that I should be able to assemble tomorrow. It's the little things. hair in there. I got it on without the magnifier, but I'll never be able to see if it's straight. Okay, other side. Let me see. Going to be a couple decals that are going to have to go on. I swear they're going to have to go on after I flat coat, because I got a couple things that go on the canopy. I'll have to see how tight the masking is. Maybe it'll go right up against the masking. If I can lay it around the masking, I think it'll be okay. Put the decal on the little hatch for sure. Okay, so that's all four of those. And on the hatch goes 77. And on this one goes 76. So this one's actually 76. And the other one is 77. Thanks, Gavster. Slowly coming together. If I quit making little oopsies. It might actually start looking like a plane sometime tomorrow. Oh, I gotta look at the scan. 76, 77. Short and longer. Dear, drop the hell out of that. Now let me see if I can see it to make sure I'm putting it right side up. Maybe if I turn it this way. Something and tools, but this is right side up. This is tiny. Good God. It's on such a huge bubble of water right now. Huge compared to it. Still can't read it. I can clearly see it says end tools now. How is that supposed to go? Where is it supposed to go? It's supposed to go straight with the hinge. Nope, that was almost it. That's it. It's tiny, tiny. It's not going to focus. And then the other one goes on to this hatch. Yes. Right there. What else do I have one on here? 114. What is 78? You know, they show you, if you can see this, they show you it's number 68, and they show you where it goes, and then right next to it they show you the decal, but they only show it as big as it is over here. They should bump it up a couple sizes so you can read what the hell it says. What are they doing? They're just messing with me now. I'm gonna see this hatch so I can get the same sort of placement. Whoops. Oh, this one is so tiny. That's it, straight away. Nailed it. Now don't move. Nailed it. This is what am I looking at here? 114 goes in that little square. Same on both sides. Yeah. And then 78 114. Oh my God. I'm skipping 78. It looks like one word. And it's on the olive drab, so it's not even gonna ever show. This gets framed by a little panel detail. other side gets that, but the other side also gets, I think it's 102. 102. And that goes in that square. You caught me though. It's not realistic. You know, actually, that's very historically inaccurate because it's missing decal number 78. Magnifier, I can't even tell if that's straight. So that's it for that, except for these mirrors. And am I gonna go with the shark's teeth? Because I don't have a diagram. I don't have a picture of how the shark's teeth go, so I don't have any reference on how to place them. Do I want to do them? I'll tell you what, if I do, because there's so many panel lines involved, I'm going to do those after I do the pin wash. If I do them, because I'm not doing, like I said, I'm not doing 23 skidoo, so far the plane's going to look pretty plain with just the numbers and emblems and no other type of artwork or anything. I'm not always bent on building a certain officer's plane. Several of my planes I've made up the marking combinations just off the cuff, just, you know, whatever looked cool. And historically there was no plane that flew those numbers, but that's okay. Cause like one of the TBF Avengers I did, you know, I was supposed to be all dressed up like George Bush's Avenger. And sorry, I just wasn't into it. I didn't need to replicate George Bush's TBF Avenger. Just wasn't high on my list. It really is a demerit to some guys, man. Some guys take that shit very seriously. 102. I have 2 102s. Does that mean one goes here? It does. 102 is also very freaking small. Where do the mirrors go? I think I'm going to hang off on the mirrors until... Yeah, there's a lot of panel lining right around them. I'm going to hang back on the mirrors until 100. Is there one of those there? 100. Centered up. Skip that. You will never see that next to the drop tanks. But I'm going to go with this one because it's down lower. Instructions and see what decals, if any, go on the drop tanks, in fact. baby. Be straight. Not that straight. Now I can see that that says fire ext. Goes there, right next to where the mirror goes, and I'll be okay to hold off on that. Where is it? Yeah, that'll be fine. And before I go any further, I want to get some solution on these. Already got that. I wish that this would give me a little better set into the panel lines here. I got a couple little features. The clear parts of the decal are looking real good. Just want to get a little better set into those panel lines. If I get real good set on those panel lines, then I'll put a 68 on top of that. But the way it's looking over there, I'm on several applications. It doesn't seem to be giving me what I want. Thanks, Dickie. Is there supposed to be something in that. Yes, there is. 101. On both of them. And this little jobber right here. Oh, good Lord. There's decals all over the place. Nope, need you to move, need you to move. So, I guess we can call this good practice. When I get to my F-14 Tomcat, that thing's got about a bazillion little tiny stencil decals. as small as some of these other decals are, it might have been worth it for me to separate that into two, so that there wasn't such a huge piece of clear film. Don't spill my water. Okay, schmokey. I think, I got one more to do on here. I don't like the way this one came out, so I'm going to skip it on the number. awesome. Don't move. Sweet meat. So the only two that I need to do are the mirror and that one, and the mirror and that one. The landing gear bay doors. I don't see any decals on there. Dang. God, there's plenty on the belly when I get her flipped upside down, and I've still got the prop decals to do. So I think what I need to do is get out a knife and cut that times two and I can pull that tail section off. Yes, I have a knife out, but I need a new blade to do this with so that we take no chances. And I'm not ready for a new blade overall, so I'm going to do this with this blade and then put it back instead of putting it in a knife. That does not hold it very well. Okay. Ooh, baby. Okay, and then I want to treat the edges with some setting solution to ensure I don't have like a flappy fringe. Nobody wants a flappy fringe. Hey man, welcome. Thank you for the raid. That's much appreciated. I'm Texas Goal. Thanks for the follow. I'm working on decals here on the side booms, because of course it would be a lot easier to lay these on the side of the side boom instead of when it's sitting upright. Scotty Rotten, thanks for the follow, much appreciated. Look at that, I'm two away from 70 now. So what I just did is I just laid this decal across the rudder, and I just cut it open, just cut the rudder open, because the rudder will need to come off to install the tail. I'm getting real close to assembling this, putting the final assembly on it. But I was trying to do as much as I could on the side booms while they're loose, because it's much easier to work on. I don't have a rig that'll stand the plane up and down so that I'll be, you know, working down on these. So I'm just getting ready, because I just sliced this open, I'm just getting ready to put some setting solution on these edges to make sure that they stay down. I don't have any flapping decals there. I'll see you, War Duck. Thanks for the raid. There we go. I also, while I had it down, I also did the pin wash on the tail section, just from here back, and I did these little access compartments. So I laid most of the small stencil decals to get those out of the way while it's on its side, and I have two more decals to do, but I'll go ahead and put it together and save those for after the main pin wash. So that should be good here. Then I gotta do the same thing for this one. I already sliced this with a brand new razor blade. And I just want to make sure that the edge is treated and down, because it was kind of floating over the gap for the rudder. So yeah, man, I want to thank everybody for joining me. I don't get very many viewers in these parts, so this is what I'm working on. It's my P-38. Let's see if the camera will show. I had some pretty good subtle color variation. There we go. So it's looking pretty good. So this is all ready to go. And I'll be tomorrow probably, I'll be installing the booms and putting on all these small pieces. I got the nose loaded up with the guns. I'll be able to put the nose on. And of course, I actually had to pop one of my props apart earlier today. Make sure I was getting spin, and I'm not getting spin. What is up? I bored that out and everything. It was spinning perfectly free this morning. Thanks, Jaffas. Jaffa's models. So I just have this cap. The cone cap is just glued on with white glue, so if I gotta take that off and make this function, that is something I will do. So that one's running. I should have noted which one was which that I worked on this morning. I can feel what's going on there. That's going on a little stiff right at the end, like this is stretching the little grommet out, and then the little grommet is grabbing the sides. I know, man, no spin. Feels bad, man. Well, there's a little link there in my page that goes to my YouTube, and for all my planes I do a motion video of the props spinning. I blow the props and shoot a video, and I get the appropriate audio for the proper engine types. So having that prop spin freely is pretty important to me. And part of my whole thing all along this build is having two booms. If something was good on one boom, man, it bugged the hell out of me if it wasn't good on the other. So let me see what I can do for this. This might be the one I worked on, because I actually think I see a little smudge of glue. Yeah, this is the one I worked on this morning. And like I said, man, when I put it back together this morning, it was spinning free. There we go. Yeah, this is the one. The glue's still just a little bit gummy. There's a little grommet, and I had a little piece of sandpaper. Where'd it go? I'm gonna switch views here. That's my GoPro gooseneck. That thing creaks and whines every time I move it. And my piece of crap 1998 camera. Here it is. So what I was doing is, I'm gonna get a new piece of sandpaper. This one's pretty worn. Perfect length right there. Them Brits. Yeah, I don't know what else to do for it other than, I mean, I got a little bit of paint down inside there, so I understand that's why it was doing it initially. And I've cleaned it out. That the other pop, the one that spins great, that one I cleaned out before. And this one was fine. All right, Jaffa, man, I appreciate you stopping by. Are you streamer too? I got everybody that just followed me. I'll be sure when I get off stream here to follow everybody back. I love checking out a good stream as much as the next guy. So I'll see you, Jaffa. Have a good night. The only other thing I could do is get some graphite powder. I mean, that should do it right there. That should be it. I opened that thing up. Before I go wild, let me check on this one. They spin, the props spin toward each other over the top. Come on, baby. Yeah, that's a champ. After I assemble this into the main body, I'll make sure that this face here is all completely smooth. And so now it's time to close this up again. Any job worth doing is worth doing twice, and I've done this one 3 times, so it must be a pretty awesome job. Oh, cool. Really, restores old World War II photos. That's awesome. And does it live on stream. That's real cool. If only my stream was half that cool. That would just be awesome. Either that, or if I had big tits. That's how you succeed as a streamer, when you're only this interesting. Oh, what do we say? Dog hair. Come on, go together. There we go. Getting glue on the prop plate. Come on. What is the dealio? This will not do. Okay, so let me see here. What could be binding? I open that channel up. Get all this glue off of here. Let's see here. What is going on? Get a clean toothpick. Push this grommet back in there. Can really do is tap this out a little more. Yuki-san! Konnichiwa! Oh no. Yeah, I can't keep up with that. That as clean as can be, tapped out all the way down. See if this will stick here at all without any glue on it. I am perplexed, man. There's a little little spinny action. Maybe when I'm blowing on it, I'm blowing it back against this. Yeah, 250 hours. Congratulations. I might do 250 hours just on this plane. That'd be pretty sad, but I'm going to avoid gluing this back on until I set the booms and then I'll try again to make sure that I have spinach. That one's great, man. That one's great and it's smooth. That one's just not playing right. Let me see something here. I'm getting a little buzz from all this blowing. I wonder if these grommets are all the same. Best stream ever. So let me see. Yep, fits on there just the same. So maybe this is causing some sticking. Let me clean that. Tiniest little bit of alcohol. Because I really think the channel way is clean. I think that's the ticket. Still not going to glue that back on. I mean, note which one this is. Counterclockwise looking at it. Okay. So I'm going to put these over here where they're safe. Still got to glue that back on. Got to keep that in mind. Got some little 1 to 72 dudes here. Little spare grommet. Put that in there. All right. So now I got a nice buzz from blowing too much. I know people that pay good money for that effect. Okay. Time is at 8:30. All right, I'm gonna plan out how to move ahead tomorrow, and I'm gonna try to not do too much. I find that when the night starts getting on and I keep going and going and going, that's usually when I make a mistake. You know, and I've made some bad mistakes in the late hours, and then I go to bed thinking, why did I do that? How am I gonna fix that? So let me see. Moving ahead, I need some small parts. And these little jobbers. And I'm probably still not going to put the nose on yet. I don't want to snap the guns. So, but let's dry fit the booms one last time. And get a view on where I'll need to touch up. I am expecting touch ups at some of the joins because everything was painted separately. I can shut that off. Well, there's a little different quality between here and here, but it sure doesn't look like anything that I'm going to paint over. While I'm thinking of it, I'm dealing with small parts. These were just sitting in there. Yeah, they're still just sitting in there. They just fit. Yeah, they just fit well. Okay. For some reason, in the tail boom back here somewhere, there was a hole, and the instructions pointed out this hole and said, fill, just straight up fill the hole. And I don't understand why they did that. But I also have a hole here and a hole here that are drawn in the instructions, but it doesn't say to fill them, and nothing goes there. It's like the damnedest thing. Yeah, the hole's there, there and there, and nothing goes in there. It doesn't say fill. In fact, it says to drill it. 1.2 millimeter hole. I don't remember drilling that. It's real clean. It looks like it's molded or made that way. But it wants a 1.2 millimeter hole, and there's nothing that goes there. I just don't get it. I don't get it. And then these will go in. That little dip goes down. This is what I was worried would be. I mean, those three pieces have three different qualities. I might have to spray a little, just a misting, to bring those together so that they look like one, you know what I mean? Unless I can find a piece that looks like it belongs there. That's close. It still has a little different quality. It might also be that it's not sanded. I don't think I sanded those. They're speed holes. That's right, man. I just need to accept that. They make it go fast. Pieces of sandpaper here. Yeah, I might have to give that just a little. I don't know. I'll tell you what, I'm going to get them in place and sand first. Let me grab a prop. So that's what she's going to be looking like. I debated about also painting the wingtips the chrome yellow with the white stripe, but I opted not. I have so many planes with colored wingtips that I thought it looked too dressed up. You know, this is sort of like squadron insignia sort of stuff. The wingtips too, I just thought she looked dressed up. see, I'm gonna have to polish this face nice and glassy smooth. And I think I'm ready to do that. I think that's what I'm gonna do tomorrow. Get started about 9-10 o'clock. Seems there's going to be a little gray touch here. The outer wings look good. The outer wing roots. Yep, I think that's going to be me tomorrow. I'm going to be assembling this sucker. I'm going to put the tail wing on. And I'm going to do some little touch-up painting before I do the assembly. I am going to hit that little white dot there next to the decal. I'm going to need to pull the landing gear bay doors. Maybe I ought to finish the landing gear bays before I set the booms. See, I had a plan. I'm second guessing myself already. Can't get my finger in there. There we go. I won't be setting those until very late in the game. That is a hulking fuel tank. Don't want to stay in the holes. Still wondering if I had to paint those little legs another color. Leave them gray. Paint them something like German gray, or, you know, just for difference. Now this one's out. There we go, man. She's coming along. I think this is probably the longest break aside, this is the longest I've ever worked on a model. See, I laid this decal to play with the Mark Fit Strong, and I slopped some around here to see if it was going to affect the paint, and I think I can see which one I did it on, but it really doesn't look like it affected the paint much. But the way it bleached that gray down to an almost white blotch. That's troublesome. And then these little weights, these little tiny counterweights for the elevator, they'll go very late. They're candidates for being broken off. So I got a lot of late stage stuff. So yeah, I'm gonna pull the landing gear bays. I'm gonna put the landing gear in tomorrow. Nope. See, this is why I sit here and think about this stuff. If I just moved ahead on my first impression of what to do, I'd make mistakes. The landing gear bay doors are on to protect these little tiny, tiny things that work as the door actuators. And I'm gonna need to pull the landing gear bay doors off when I do the pin wash around here and around here. So I'm gonna wanna leave the landing gear bay doors on. I'm gonna wanna put the model together, paint my touch-ups. I'm gonna have to clear coat again after the touch-ups. And right before I clear coat, I'll pull the landing gear bay doors out of the way. And I'll clear coat the top side, and then right before I clear coat the bottom, I'll pull the landing gear bay doors out of the way, and you know, what I should do is I should do the big decals, because I'm not going to have any touch-up all the way out here. So before I do another clear coat, no, I want to do all the panel lines before I do decals. Because I have so many little tiny stencil decals that go in all these little panel marks, and I don't want to have to pin wash around them. They shouldn't matter, but I don't want to sweep them off of there with the sponge. So I'm going to assemble it tomorrow. I'm going to touch up. I'm going to clear coat. And then I'm going to pull the doors off and clear coat the belly, pin wash the belly. And then I'll rebuild the landing gear bays, put the rest of the landing gear in, put in that last piece of hydraulic line that is blocked by the landing gear. And then I'll be ready to flip her over. Well, before I do that, I can do the decals on the bottom, and then I'll be ready to flip her over. And work on pin washing the top. Whew. Hey, Alien. You're having a meltdown doing this tank. Well, you said you wanted to get two of them done tonight for primer tomorrow. That's a big undertaking, man. Wiping out two tanks. I like did one thing all night. I got like next to nothing done. So since I got this dry fit together, I'm gonna take a picture, because we're all about pictures on my stream for my build log. Oh yeah, I can waste a lot of time looking for lost parts. I always put it where the light won't reach. Isn't it? So now I want to get a pictures of the decal work on the side booms. These always screw with me trying to take these back apart. That one didn't. There we go. Over here. Props are in a safe spot. Don't. Got me taking a selfie. That'll do. Okay, so tomorrow will be a big day because it'll actually be a whole plane then. Yeah, man. I may. If, you know, if I feel him out and he's into it, I may give this to my father when I'm all done. I've mentioned on stream a bunch that my father flew in the Navy in the 50s. He flew P-2V and a Trojan, T-28 Trojan, and an S-2F tracker, a Grumman tracker. But he always told me that growing up when he was a kid during World War II, the P-38 was his dream. It was his, just, you know, being a kid and fantasizing about flying and all that. The P-38 was what he thought of when he thought of airplanes. And then he told me when he got into the Navy and he qualified for instruments and Lieutenant junior grade and was full-fledged pilot, he was scared to death they were going to put him in a Sky Raider. He just saw it coming. They're going to put me in a Sky Raider. I just know it. And that meant he'd be out there killing the Viet Cong. But he left the Navy and he didn't stay in the Navy past the 50s. But he doesn't like tail draggers. He likes his twin engine tricycle landing gear. But the twin engine single seat trike landing gear P-38 was his dream plane. So I might gift it to my dad when I'm done. We shall see. And of course, when he passes, they'll all come back to me anyway. He's not that I'm like think that's on the horizon, but he's a good 80 bunch years old, so he's getting up there. Every time I see him, I'm like, damn, Dad, you are getting old, dude. So, but I think that's gonna be me for the evening. I got a lot done tonight with getting the decals out of the way. I got a plan in place for tomorrow. And I'm all about the plan. So, all my new peeps, Yeah, I need to make signs for the lamps. Thanks, Alien. Thanks, Alien. Yeah, man, all the new peeps that are still hanging out, I appreciate you guys stopping by. Appreciate all the new follows. Up to 69 now. 69 followers. What a landmark follow number. So appreciate everybody coming by. I'll be on tomorrow getting a lot more done. Hopefully things are going to pick up now that I'm done the tedious of the tail. Just getting through the tail because I had all the other small stuff was already complete, so there weren't other things I could do while I was waiting for the tail to dry in stages and stuff. So things I'm hoping things are going to pick up, and I might even be complete by next weekend. So and the social alien will be making tanks. You streaming that? I'll be over there, check you out before I hit the hay, alien. Yeah, man. Or actually, we got seven people. Is your stream up? I got nobody to raid. So you ought to turn on stream alien so we can raid you before I sign off. No. Okay then. Maybe another time. So that's gonna be it. Everybody have a good night, and I look forward to seeing y'all tomorrow. Boo-hoo, boo from the Cavster. Boo on the alien. Get your stream running, bro. I'll see y'all. Have a good night. Thanks for watching.